My own research is controversial. The idea of morphic resonance and memory in nature is unfamiliar to many scientists, and it's not the way they usually think. And the research I do on unexplained phenomena of animals and people, including telepathy and the sense of direction in animals and in people, breaks certain taboos within the scientific world. So some skeptics are very opposed to what I do. They dismiss it as pseudoscience because it doesn't fit in with the ordinary mainstream science research program. Others say that it must be flawed, they make a lot of dismissive remarks. But I've actually had public debates with quite a lot of my critics, and anyone who wants to hear them can hear them for themselves on the internet. And what's come out over and over and over again is that they're actually not interested in the evidence. They're so sure they're right that the evidence is irrelevant. So this isn't really proper skepticism. This is a kind of dogmatic dismissal. And it's not really very scientific. So anyone who hears skeptics making remarks really needs to ask, where's the skeptic coming from? Is it from a dogmatic position, or is it from a genuinely open-minded position looking at the evidence? And of course, looking at the evidence being in an open-minded way is very important. It's part of science. It's what we need. It's healthy. It's normal. But the dogmatic dismissal of anything that doesn't fit in with what one believes is really a kind of fundamentalism. And I think it holds back science rather than leads it forward.